Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture video of System Software and Compilers Module 2. In this lecture, we will be looking at language processors and structure of compilers. Language processors, as the name suggests, are the such softwares which process a program given in a certain source language. There are various types of language processors such as compilers, interpreters, preprocessors and assemblers. A compiler is a program that can read a program in one language, that is a source language, and translate it into an equivalent program in another language, that is a target language. If the target program is an executable machine level language program, it can then be called by the user to process inputs and produce outputs. A compiler is also expected to report errors if the source program has errors in it. It can be pictorially represented as shown. An interpreter is another common kind of language processor. Instead of producing a target program as a translation, an interpreter appears to directly execute the operations specified in the source program on inputs supplied by the user. The machine language target program produced by a compiler is usually much faster than interpreter at mapping inputs to outputs. An interpreter, however, can usually give better error diagnostics than a compiler because it executes the source program statement by statement. It can be pictorially represented as shown. Hybrid compiler is another language processor which accepts the source program maybe in a bytecode format. This intermediate program along with input data is fed as the input to the virtual machine and the output can be obtained. It can be pictorially represented as shown. An assembler is a language processor which accepts assembly level language as its input and produces the target language as its output. A linker is used to resolve external memory references and a loader is used to load the executable file onto main memory. Hybrid compiler is another language processor which accepts the source program maybe in a bytecode format. This intermediate program along with input data is fed as the input to the virtual machine and the output can be obtained. It can be pictorially represented as shown. An assembler is a language processor which accepts assembly level language as its input and produces the target language as its output. A linker is used to resolve external memory references and a loader is used to load the executable file onto main memory. Hybrid compiler is another language processor which accepts the source program maybe in a bytecode format. This intermediate program along with input data is fed as the input to the virtual machine and the output can be obtained. It can be pictorially represented as shown. An assembler is a language processor which accepts assembly level language as its input and produces the target language as its output. A linker is used to resolve external memory references and a loader is used to load the executable file onto main memory. Hybrid compiler is another language processor which accepts the source program maybe in a bytecode format. This intermediate program along with input data is fed as the input to the virtual machine and the output can be obtained. It can be pictorially represented as shown. An assembler is a language processor which accepts assembly level language as its input and produces the target language as its output. A linker is used to resolve external memory references and a loader is used to load the executable file onto main memory. Now we'll see language processing system. An entire language processing system is as shown. In addition to a compiler, several other programs may be required to create an executable target program. A source program may be divided into modules and stored in separate files. The task of collecting the source program is sometimes given to a separate program called preprocessor. And the preprocessor may also expand the shorthands called macros into source language statements. The modified source program is then fed to a compiler. The compiler may produce an assembly language program as its output because assembly level language is easier to produce as output and is easier to debug. The assembly language is then processed by a program called an assembler that produces relocatable machine code as its output. Large programs are often compiled in pieces, so the relocatable machine code may have to be linked together with other relocatable object files and library files into the code that actually runs on the machine. The linker resolves the external memory addresses where the code in one file may refer to a location in another file. And the loader then puts together all of the executable object files into a memory for execution. Analysis, synthesis, model of compilation. There are two parts of a compilation: analysis and synthesis. The analysis part breaks up the source program into constituent pieces and imposes a grammatical structure on them. It then uses this structure to create an intermediate representation of the source program. If the analysis part detects that source program is either syntactically ill-formed or semantically unsound, then it must provide informative messages so the user can take corrective action. The analysis part also collects the information about the source program and stores it in a data structure called a symbol table, which is passed along with the intermediate representation to the synthesis part. The synthesis part constructs the desired target program from the intermediate representation and the information in the symbol table. The analysis part is often called the front end of the compiler and the synthesis part as the back end. If we examine the compilation process in more detail, we see that it operates as a sequence of phases, each of which transforms one representation of the source program to another. A typical decomposition of a compiler into phases is as shown in the figure. In practice, several phases may be grouped together, and the intermediate representations between the grouped phases need to be constructed explicitly. The symbol table, which stores the information about the entire source program, is used by all the phases of the compiler. Some compilers have a machine independent optimization phase between the front end and the back end. The purpose of this optimization phase is to perform transformations on the intermediate representation so that the back end can produce a better target program than it would have otherwise produced from an unoptimized intermediate representation. Since the optimization is optional, one or the other of the two optimization phases shown in the figure may be missing. The first phase of a compiler is called lexical analysis or scanning. The lexical analyzer reads the stream of characters making up the source program and groups the characters into a meaningful sequences called lexemes. For each lexeme, the lexical analyzer produces as output a token of the form token name and attribute value that it passes on to the subsequent phase, that is syntax analysis. In the token, the first component that is a token name is an abstract symbol that is used during syntax analysis, and the second component attribute value points to an entry in the symbol table for this token. The information from the symbol table entry is needed for semantic analysis and code generation. For example, suppose a source program contains the assignment statement. The characters in this assignment statement could be grouped into the following lexemes and mapped into the following tokens passed on to the syntax analyzer. The first one, the position, is a lexeme that would be mapped into a token ID, 1. Where ID is an abstract symbol standing for identifier, and 1 points to the symbol table entry for position. The symbol table entry for an identifier holds the information about the identifier, such as its name and type. The assignment symbol equal to is a lexeme that is mapped into the token equal to. Since this token needs no attribute value, we have omitted the second component. We could have used any abstract symbol such as assign for the token name, but for notational convenience, we have chosen to use the lexeme itself as the name of the abstract symbol. Okay. Now, initial is a lexeme that is mapped into the token ID, 2, where 2 is 2 points to the symbol table entry for initial. Plus is a lexeme that is mapped into the token plus. Rate is a lexeme that is mapped into the token ID comma 3, where 3 points to the symbol table entry for the rate. Star is a lexeme that is mapped into the token star, and 60 is a lexeme that is mapped into the token 60. Syntax analysis. The second phase of a compiler is syntax analysis or parsing. The parser uses the first components of the tokens produced by the lexical analyzer to create a tree-like intermediate representation that depicts the grammatical structure of the token stream. A typical representation is a syntax tree in which each interior node represents an operation, and the children of the node represent the arguments of the operation. A syntax tree for the token stream is shown as the output of the syntax analyzer. This tree shows the order in which the operations in the assignment statement are to be performed. The tree has an interior node labeled star with ID comma 3 as its left child and the integer 60 as its right child. The node ID comma 3 represents the identifier rate. The node labeled star makes it explicit that we must first multiply the value of rate by 60. The node labeled plus indicates that we must add the result of this multiplication to the value of initial. The root of the tree labeled equal to indicates that we must store the result of this addition into the location of for the identifier position. This ordering of operations is consistent with the usual conventions of arithmetic, which tell us that multiplication has higher precedence than addition, and hence that multiplication is to be performed before the addition. The subsequent phases of the compiler use the grammatical structure to help the and they analyze the source program and generate the target program. Semantic analysis. The semantic analyzer uses the syntax tree and the information in the symbol table to check the source program for semantic consistency with the language definition. It also gathers type information and saves it in either the syntax tree or the symbol table for subsequent use during intermediate code generation. An important part of semantic analysis is type checking, where the compiler checks that each operator has matching operands. For example, Many programming language definitions require an array index to be an integer. The compiler must report an error if a floating point number is used to index an array. The language specification may permit some type conversions called coercions. For example, a binary arithmetic operator may be applied to either a pair of integers or to a pair of floating point numbers. If the operator is applied to a floating point number and an integer, the compiler may convert or coerce the integer into a floating point number. Such a coercion appears in the figure. Suppose that the position, initial and rate have been declared to be floating point numbers, and that the lexeme 60 by itself forms an integer. The type checker in the semantic analyzer in the figure discovers that the operator multiplication is applied to a floating point number rate and an integer 60. In this case, the integer may be converted into a floating point number. In figure, we can notice that the output of the semantic analyzer has an extra node for the operator int to float, which explicitly converts its integer argument into a floating point number. In the process of translating a source program into a target code, a compiler may construct one or more intermediate representations which can have a variety of forms. Syntax trees are a form of intermediate representation. They are commonly used during syntax and semantic analysis. After the syntax and semantic analysis of the source program, many compilers generate an explicit low-level or machine-like intermediate representation, which we can think of as a program for an abstract machine. This intermediate representation should have two important properties. The first one, it should be easy to produce, and second one, it should be easy to translate into the target machine. We consider an intermediate form called three-address code, which consists of a sequence of assembly-like instructions with three operands per instruction. Each operand can act like a register. The output of the intermediate code generator in the figure consists of the three-address code sequence. There are several important points about three-address instructions. First, each three-address assignment instruction has at most one operator on the right-hand side. Thus, these instructions fix the order in which the operations are to be done. The multiplication precedes the addition in the source program. Second, the compiler must generate a temporary name to hold the value computed by a three address instruction. Third one is that some three address instructions like the first and the last in the sequence have fewer than three operands. The machine independent code optimization phase attempts to improve the intermediate code so that better target code will result. Usually better means the faster, but other objectives may be desired, such as shorter code or target code that consumes the less power. For example, a straightforward algorithm generates the intermediate code using an instruction for each operator in the tree representation that comes from the semantic analyzer. A simple intermediate code generation algorithm followed by code optimization is a reasonable way to generate a good target code. The optimizer can deduce that the conversion of 60 from integer to floating point can be done once and for all at compile time. So the into to float operation can be eliminated by replacing the integer 60 by the floating point number 60.0. Moreover, T3 is used only once to transmit its value to ID1. So the optimizer can transform the code into the shorter sequence. There is a great variation in the amount of code optimization that different compilers perform. In those compilers that do the most, the so-called optimizing compilers, a significant amount of time is spent on this phase. There are simple optimizations that significantly improve the running time of the target program without slowing down the compilation too much. The code generator takes the input an intermediate representation of the source program and maps it into the target language. If the target language is machine code, then the registers or memory locations are selected for each of the variables used by the program. Then the intermediate instructions are translated into sequences of machine instructions that perform the same task. A crucial aspect of code generation is the judicious assignment of registers to hold the variables. For example, using registers R1 and R2, the intermediate code in the figure might get translated into the machine code. The first operand of each instruction specifies a destination. The F in each instruction tells us that it deals with the floating point numbers. The code in the figure loads the content of address ID 3 into the register R2. then multiplies it with the floating point constant 60.0. The hash in the second instruction signifies that 60.0 is to be treated as an immediate constant. The third instruction moves the ID2 into the register R1, and the fourth instruction adds to it the value previously computed in the register R2. Finally, the value in register R1 is stored into the address of ID1. So the code correctly implements the assignment statement.